Hi everyone, you're welcome to another wonderful class in this our awesome learning platform. I am Miss Olayinka, and today we'll be looking at religion and national values, social studies. Religion and national values, social studies. And in today's social studies class, under religion and national values, we're talking about drug abuse. Wow, drug abuse. This is drug here. And the caption says, drug abuse. Wow. Now, I want you to pay close attention to the class because you'll be needing a lot of information you'll be getting from this class. At the end of the class, you'll be able to define for me, you should be able to define for me drug abuse. What is drug abuse? You should be able to make sure the causes or factors that leads to drug. What are the factors? What are the causes? What makes somebody just wake up one day and say, I want to go into drug. I want to go into drugs. I want to start abusing drugs. What makes people do that? And then you should be able to tell me those are the, what kind of drugs or substances people can abuse, and then what are the effects of drug abuse. When somebody begin to go into drug abuse or begin to abuse drug, what are the repercussions? What are the consequences? What are the effects? Because somebody cannot just be doing something that's negative and don't expect a negative effect. So when you go into something that's negative, you should know that there's going to be a negative effect that will come to, that will catch up with you. So at the end of the class, you'll be able to tell me those people that are going to drug, what is the effect? Will tell me that, what are those drugs that they can abuse? And then, why do people abuse such drugs? Okay, let's go and look at what drug abuse is. Now we have some drugs here, okay? Different kinds of drugs, very attractive. And because of that, some people might want to take them because they are attractive, not knowing what they are meant for, and not even knowing what they are, how the quantity or the prescription from a qualified or a medical practitioner or even a pharmacist, they will not bother because the drugs are looking beautiful and somebody has told them, maybe a friend or maybe a chemist somewhere has told them that just take it and it will ease your pain, and then they take it. Now look at the picture of a drug here, some drugs here. Now let's go to what drug abuse is. Now drug abuse is a process of using drugs without the prescription of a specialist who is either a doctor or a pharmacist. Can you see that? The process of using drugs without the prescription of a specialist who can either be a doctor or a pharmacist. What do they tell you? Before you can take any drug, you must get the prescription from either a doctor or a pharmacist. And both of them must be qualified, not quacks. They must be qualified doctors, not quack, because we have some quack doctors that do a lot of things these days. So before you can go and get a drug from anybody, you must be a qualified doctor or a qualified pharmacist. Now, I said that drug abuse is the act of using drugs and substances for a purpose different from the one for which the drug has been prescribed. So people, they will go to a pharmacist and a doctor, and they will give them the right prescription, but they will use it for something different, a different purpose. And in such cases, they are abusing such drugs. And I can also say it is the habitual taking of illegal drugs. We'll be looking at some illegal drugs today. Habitual taking of illegal drugs is what we call drug abuse. So you can see I've given you different definitions for you to be able to pick anyone you like. It is the habitual taking. When you say something is habitual, it means you like doing it regularly. And it has become your habit. It has become your behavior. It has become part and parcel of you. Now that is what we call habitual taking of illegal drugs. Now let's go to what are the factors that lead to drug abuse. There are certain factors that can affect the likelihood and speed of development of addiction. There are some things, there are some factors that can make addiction, that can speed up addiction. We're going to be looking at them in the next slide. Now, family history of addiction. If you have a mother or a father that is into drugs, wow, the children should be very careful, because if they're not careful, they're also going to go into drug. Yes. So family history of addiction. If you have a mother that is into drugs or that is doing alcohol, wow, children should be very careful. That's family history. Or you have a sister that is doing it, the brother should be careful. Or if the brother is doing it, the sister should also watch out. Their mental health disorder. When some people are not mentally okay, they tend to go into drugs, thinking that that's the way out, or because of ignorance, because they might not know what they are doing, somebody will now begin to give them drug and they'll be taking it because they are mad, because they are mentally not okay. They are not mentally okay. So mental disorder can also cause drug abuse. Then peer pressure, adolescence. Well, my friends are doing it. I also want to do it. That's peer pressure. That's what we call it, pressure. They will pressurize you. The pressure will be so much on you. You want to be like them. You want to do what they are doing. You want to go along with them. You want to look like them. You want to feel among. You want to belong. You don't want them to look at you as if you're a baby. You don't want them to look at you as if you don't understand what's happening. You don't want them to begin to look at you as if you are seeing mommy's pet or daddy's pet. And because of that, you want to do what they are doing. That's peer pressure. And adolescents as well. You don't want mommy and daddy to continue to order you around or you want to be independent. You don't want to be dependent on mommy and daddy again. You want to be independent. You feel you are old enough, you're matured enough to take decisions and to do things by yourself. You begin to move around with friends and those friends are bad and you don't want to leave them. And before you know what's happening, you start taking what they are taking, which is drug, and you begin to abuse it. Now, taking a highly addictive drug, that is also causes of drug abuse. There are some drugs that are meant for a particular ailment, but they are high. They are high on that ailment. And because you didn't go to the doctor or the pharmacist to ask what the drugs are actually meant for, you start taking them. And by the time you start taking them, you begin to get used to them. And then if you don't take them for some time, you now begin to feel someone, you feel restless, and before it's happening, you're abusing that drug. Do you know that somebody can abuse ordinary paracetamol? Yes, by the time you take 3-4 paracetamols in a day because you have headache, you're abusing it. You're not supposed to take more than the prescription of the doctor. And you now begin to take 4-5. So people say, I'm so tired, I've worked myself, I want to take paracetamol, you take 5. Then it becomes abuse. Now, let's go to more causes of drug abuse. Ignorance. Somebody just pick up something and start using it on his or herself without knowing the repercussion, without knowing the effect, without knowing what that particular drug is meant for. You just saw a drug, maybe in your daddy's drawer or your daddy's cupboard, or you just saw it in your brother's cupboard or your friend's place, and you don't know what it's meant for. You just took it ignorantly. And you notice that when you took it, it felt somehow on you. And the next time, you just continue to take it. That's drug abuse, ignorance. Then severity of sickness. Does that mean? If parent or maybe the person himself that is sick feels that, I have used paracetamol, I have used Flagyl, I have used this, I have used that, and my sickness is still persisting. Okay, let me use something stronger. And then, before you know what's happening, the sickness, because you're so much sick, or you feel the sickness is very much, you now begin to take the kind of drug that you're not supposed to take. And by the time, you know, some people, when they take 3-4 paracetamol, they will feel better. Because they feel that the headache is too much, they will take 4 paracetamol, 5 paracetamol. And when they take it, for that time, they will feel better. And now get to a time, if they don't take more than, if they don't take 3 or 4 paracetamol, their headache will not leave them alone. That is abuse. They have abused paracetamol. They have said to abuse that drug. Because you're not supposed to take more than the prescription. You now begin to take 4 and 5. And as time goes on, your headache will not persist until you have taken 5. Now, self-medication is another reason why people go into drug abuse. Self-medication. You don't want to go to the hospital. You are feeling somehow. You just quickly go to a chemist down the street. You go, please give me Flagyl. Give me this. And you mix everything up and you take it. That's drug abuse. Then poor quality of drug. Maybe the drug has even expired. You don't know. You just go and buy it at the chemist down the street and then you take it. And it has expired. The quality of the drug has gone. There's no quality in that drug again. It's an expired drug. And you use it. That's another cause of drug abuse. Now we go to the classes of drugs. What are the kind of drugs that we have? Drugs can be grouped into 4 classes. I will mention them for you now. Sorry, I mean 5. 5. I will mention the classes for you. The classes of drug. 5. Now we have sedative drugs. Sedative drugs. What do I call them? Sedative drugs. I will not be explaining them in this class. I will just mention them for you. Then in our next class, I will tell you what these drugs are. We have what they call them? Sedative drugs. Now we have 2, depressant drugs. Mm-hmm. Now we have what? Analgesic drugs. And then we have what? Stimulants. And then we have psychotemia drugs. I'll mention them again so that you click in your memory. Sedative drugs, depressant drugs, analgesic and stimulants and psychotemia Drugs. I hope you can mention them now. I'm listening. Yes, stimulants. Psychedemia. Good. Now let's go to commonly drugs that are commonly misused. Drugs commonly misused. You can see the picture of cocaine there. And they say, bro, no cocaine. Say no to cocaine. Say no to cocaine, bros and sister. Everybody, this is cocaine substance. You can see it here. In case you have not seen the cocaine, because you have not seen the substance before, this is a picture of cocaine. So those are the drugs that are commonly misused. We have marijuana, that's number one. Cocaine, number two. Opiates. Opiates are like heroin, codeine, morphine. They are opiates. They are drugs that people always misuse and they abuse. Methamphetamine. Have you seen it? Can we pronounce it together? Methamphetamine. Okay. Then we have alcohol, opioids, and then some sleep medication like Valium 5. You know, some people take Valium 5 and they'll sleep for how many hours? 24 hours. Hey, some people sleep for 2 days, 48 hours, and they take some sleep medications and they can. It's another form of drug abuse. People misuse it. They misuse sleep medications. Some people, they say they want to get fat. They go and get drug and they'll begin to misuse it. Those are sleep medications that people misuse. Now, what is the effect of drug? Let's go to the effects, because there's something that is done negatively that doesn't have your effects, either positive or negative, but in this form, this case, they are negative effects. Now look at the picture there. Effect of drug. Say no to drug. No to drugs. At your young age, even when you grow up, try to say no to drug. Anyway, you find yourself in the university, in a secondary school, on your own, while you're growing up on your working, say, please say no to drug, because they have a lot of effects. The following are some of the effects of drug abuse. Number one, bad odor or body odor. Person begin to smell. Bad odor, body odor. Now we have undue excitement. You don't even know what is making you to be happy. You'll be happy unnecessarily. You can even still see them sometimes, you'll be smiling. And you'll be wondering, what's making him to smile? That's the effect of drug. Then convulsion. Drug can make someone go into convulsion. Starts suffocating and starts gasping for air. Then we have false source of confidence. You feel so high. You feel high. You have this false confidence that is coming your way because you are on drug. You feel you can do anything. That's why some footballers, they go and take drug before they go and play the ball. And they have this confidence. And before you know what's happening, it fails them. Some people, they will go and take drugs. Some musicians, they go and take drugs before they sing their music. And they are all false sources of confidence. Some people, they want to speak in public, they will go and take drugs. Why? Because they feel that it will give them confidence. It's a false confidence that it gives them. What kind of confidence do I call it? False confidence. False. They will not feel high. I mean, feel high, not feel confident. They will feel high. It's false. What do I call it? False. Now let's go to effect still. Can see mental disorder. Look at that one. Injecting herself with cocaine or another kind of drug. Injecting herself makes you go mad. Go gaga. Makes you go mad. See a lot of mad people on the streets. What makes them mad is drug. Most of them, they go on drug. At their youthful age, they go into drugs and then they are mad. Then hallucination. You start walking and talking, start seeing things, start imagining things. That's hallucination. Then loss of appetite and weight. Be going slim, looking so haggard, looking so wretched. Then lack of saving. You'll not be able to save money because all your saving, you'll be spending it on drugs. Undue aggression. You'll be feeling angry unnecessarily. Getting angry at everybody. Shouting. Getting angry all the time. More effects, disrespect and dishonor. You'll not be able to get respect of anybody. People look at you as a wayward and a disobedient child. no dishonor, no respect for you. And then unkempt appearance, looking so haggard, looking so unkempt. Then you urged or desire to commit suicide. That person will be feeling like, what am I doing in this world? Let me just end it all. So he's feeling so depressed. Depression will come in. Depression. You'll not be looking for ways to end it all. Depression will come in. Depression. Depression. Yeah. Depression will come in. Looking for a way to end your life. You want to commit suicide because you don't know way forward. You're so confused. Then the person will not be able to fulfill purpose or destiny. Because by the time the person is mad, what is the use of the mad person? Or when the person is into drug, what it doesn't have anything thinking about again. All his mindset is how to get drug and how to use it. And then all his hard earned money, he will spend it on drug. And then since he's not balanced mentally, he will not be able to work, and then he will not be able to save, and then the purpose and the destiny is not going to be fulfilled. Then accidents. A lot of times people that go on drug, they will go and be driving. After taking alcohol, after taking cocaine, they will drive us at the same time. What happens? Accidents. Now, I have a lot of effects. Criminal or antisocial behavior, like rape. Yes, people that go into rape, you know what they take? They take drug. They take drug. Antisocial behavior. They take drug. People that go into stealing. This is small boys carrying AK-47 fighting because they want to go and steal. What do you think they are taking? They are taking drugs. And that's why their eyes will be so red and they are not bothered about anybody. They will be ready to shoot anybody and kill anybody. Why? Because they have taken drugs. Then long-term personality change. The person will change completely. I know a boy in my area, very gentle, normal, good-looking, easygoing. All of a sudden, he just became something else. In fact, he became so... anytime I come across him, I'm scared of talking to him, even greeting him, or even answering his call, his greeting. Why? Because his personality has changed. His appearance has changed. A young boy of 16, 17, his appearance has changed. Everything about him has changed. He has become somebody else. Long-term personality change and HIV/AIDS. You know why? You know why this HIV/AIDS can become the effect? Yes, because the syringe they use, that injection might not be sterilized. And there may be somebody that used it before has HIV or has AIDS. And they just pick it up and they use it to inject themselves. Use it to inject themselves with cocaine or any other thing. And before you know what's happening, they will get HIV or AIDS. And the last but not the least is death, which is the final destination of those people that refuse to go back from taking drugs. If you refuse to go back from taking drugs and you continue and you're addicted to it, there's death waiting for that fellow. Now, what do you say? No to drugs. You say what? Say no to drugs. What do I say? Say no to drugs. Keep your life. If you know anybody that is talking about drug around you, tell the person there are a lot of dangers in it. There are a lot of side negative effects in it. Tell them to run away from drugs. Say no to drugs. In conclusion, drugs and substances can be abused, and when such happens, there are several consequences and effects. So do not abuse any kind of drug. Please do not abuse any kind of drug, either paracetamol, either as simple as paracetamol or as hard as marijuana or cocaine. Now, let's come to the question aspect. Now, what is drug abuse? I gave you three definitions. I want to get it now. What is drug abuse? Good. Now, mention the causes of or factors that lead to drug abuse. What are those things? Just give me three that lead to drug abuse. Good. Now, list some drugs that can be abused. What kind of drugs? List some of them that can be abused. Good. Now, let's mention four effects of drug abuse. I give you like 20 of them. Let's just mention like four effects of drug abuse. Great. Now we have come to the end of the topic that says drug abuse. Thank you for listening and God bless you. See you tomorrow for your class activity. Bye.